Good evening. The European Championship got off to a flyer last night and two men made quite an impression on their TV debuts. William Borland sent Simon Whitlock packing and former handball player Florin Hempel dethroned the reigning champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to the Salzburg Arena here in Austria.
Oh, great dart. Beautifully done.
Oh, yes, superb. What a way to win it.
Finally, someone fancies checking out. Well done, Rob Cross, in Madhouse.
Brendan Dolan gets over the line.
It's going to be a nerve jangler, this one. Humphreys under pressure. He's got the job done.
Jose de Souza, he goes through to the last 16. Mensur Cilic takes it. Game over. Mensur gets home.
The rock star is rocking. Joe Cullen in a class of his own there.
Double trouble for the defending champ. Florin Hempel causes a huge, huge upset, dumping the defending champion and...
It was quite an evening in Salzburg yesterday, and we're looking forward to more of the same tonight with eight further first-round matches. Now we have some big names in action, including a man who's claimed this title four times. That's mighty Michael van Gerwen. James Wade triumphed in this event 3 years ago and was last year's beaten finalist. And after missing out in the final of the World Grand Prix earlier this month, the world number one, Gerwin Price, will be pumped up and ready to make amends. Well, these matches, all the best of 11 legs, all the first to six. And as you might expect, we have Chris Mason and Alan Warren a little back with us for another night of darts and debate. And there are, lads, always stories. Whatever night of darts we have for you, there's always stories to come out of it and names to emerge as well in these tournaments. And William Borland, 24-year-old from Edinburgh, take your big scalp.
Yeah, huge win for him, huge win. And he certainly doesn't lack confidence, that's for sure, and certainly doesn't lack any confidence in his own ability. But he's one of the players that have literally started right from the beginning of what they have now within the PDC, whether it be JDC, Development Tour, Challenge Tour, and then has gone on to secure a tour card. And this is the end result. He's a process of the system. And he can play a lot better than that. I've certainly seen him play a lot better than that. But considering, I think that's only his second win on stage in front of cameras, and against an established and very experienced pro in Simon Whitlock, it was a good performance. It's an exciting prospect. Every couple of years, we just keep producing them, and this is another one to look out for.
Yeah, knocking out a former European champion as well in Simon Whitlock. Is he somebody you know well, Borland?
Yeah, he's obviously a tour card holder this year. He's almost doubled his prize money, hasn't he, in one weekend and still in the tournament. Pushing for world number 60 at the moment, could even go higher. The confidence that can give you as well. But the impressive thing for me was the fact he was 2-0 down and just couldn't really get going. He missed an opportunity in one leg. He didn't fold, he kept going, he kept a bit of aggression there. He took out two really good shots, 1-4-2 to win it. And a 1-2-1 at a crucial stage of the match.
Yeah, he's guaranteed £10,000 now for reaching the next stage as well. And it'll be William Borland against Joe Cullen up next. We'll see them tomorrow, but we'll also see Florin Hempel tomorrow, a German 31-year-old people might not know too much about. He did actually qualify for the UK Open, but pulled out due to family reasons. So his first one win on TV was against a former world champion in Peter Wright.
Yeah, it was a bizarre game from Peter and a bizarre choice to start off using those darts, and then as soon as he was in a bit of trouble, he almost flapped and then went back to his original darts, the gold stone grip dart, the Euro dart, and then went back to the rather bulbous barrel, and he ultimately paid the price. So the opening three legs for Florian were outstanding. Alan was doing the commentary on the game, and it was 3-15 darters and three dart combination shots out, finding the double with his last dart, and in a blink of an eye, Peter found himself 3-0 down, and for the first time, I certainly seen him hit the panic button. He didn't quite know what to do up there, and that's a worrying sign at this start, you know, the start of a really, really important part of the season.
Are you concerned about Peter's mindset?
Well, it's not good after that, is it? I mean, changing your darts mid-leg, obviously he does it that often during matches, sometimes in the break, but to actually do it mid-leg was very, very strange, and kind of gives you a bit of a negative thought process, doesn't it, really? But he never really got into the match, didn't play well, but Florian didn't give him that many chances early on, and when he was chasing the game, he found it difficult.
Yeah.
And I think other players, you know, players like Michael van Gerwen and Gerwin Price's, they will sense a fragility there, and they'll jump all over that when they play him next. He's got to be, listen, the guy's an elite dart player. It's just, I want to see him play at his best all of the time, and when he does things like that, it's just immediately the knee-jerk reaction is to worry.
But exciting to see Florian Hempel, a German, who's now set up a tie against Menzel Sulevic.
Fantastic for him. Again, same as William Borland, almost doubled his prize money in one weekend. Massive for him, obviously. Move him up the rankings, got him into, I think, number 88 or somewhere around there. Could even go higher, obviously. But again, confidence. But we said earlier on that, we've seen Gerwin Price, a former sportsman, that sportsman's mentality, it does help because he looked really good up there. He looked really cool, calm, collective, and got the reward.
Yeah, he laughed, actually, Florian Hempel, when he's previously been compared to another sportsman who maybe has good hand-eye coordination. He said, no, I was a goalkeeper. He said, it didn't really help me at all. Mentally, it's helped me, but certainly not in terms of throwing things at a ball.
Well, I suppose he's still got to throw the ball out, hasn't he, when he gets the ball. So it's a similar kind of thing, but what Alan said is right. It's all about the mentality and understanding pressure, and he dealt with it fine.
Yeah, he said that certainly has helped him, that kind of mentality from his handball career. All these talented people to watch. Hey, let's watch a few more of them, a few more darts players tonight. Let's get our first two on stage, because our first match features a young man who'll be hoping to have a very bright future in the game. It is 19-year-old Czech player Adam Gawlas, and he takes on Bolton's Joe Murnan now. To make the introductions for us, it is our MC as ever, John McDonald.
Hello and a very warm welcome. You've joined us live from the Salzburg Arena here in Austria! It's the Kazoo European Championship that's brought to you by the Professional Darts Corporation. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for a wonderful live audience and the millions of viewers joining us around the world, it's time to meet the players. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Joe Murnan and Adam Gawlas.
There's a really good crowd in tonight. Fantastic to see. Should be a fine atmosphere. And opening the batting for us in the commentary box tonight is Chris Mason. And good evening, Ned Bolton.
Thank you, Jackie. That's better, isn't it? Proper Friday night feeling here in Salzburg. One of the most beautiful and historical cultural capitals in Europe. Enjoying culture of a very different order tonight as we have an intriguing clash to get things underway. Adam Gawlas, the man all in black there, just taking a sip of water, just 19 years of age from the Czech Republic. And he faces Joe Murnan, twice his age. Hardly a veteran though, 38 years of age. He has been around a while, the man who goes these days by the nickname of Midnight. Up against this young man, a 19-year-old from Navzi. And if your geography needs a little bit of brushing up, Navzi is pretty much as far east as you can go. And public hard up against the Polish border. In fact, Adam Gawlas is bilingual, speaks both Polish, Czech, as do many people in that region from which he hails, Moravia, Silesia. Young player who is really beginning to make his mark in the game. And Joe Murnan, well, if his opponent is all about sheer teenage promise, this man is all about grit, proven talent, stickability and durability. A man who's lost his tool card, got it back, lost it again, got it back. He just does not know when he's beaten Joe Murnan. Used to work in just a couple of years ago in a darts warehouse in Bolton before giving up his job that he'd had for 10 years to go professional in the game. And he is a fighter, a battler, determined to make a career.
Just like Joe to profess.
So two very different backgrounds, two completely different biographies, and the bookies can't split them. This could be a very, very even contest indeed.
Yeah, the bookies wimped 5-6 each of two, a genuine pick and match, and it is hard to separate them, and look how close they are in terms of the Euro rankings, 16 and 17.
16.
Well, Adam Gawlas, as we were talking about yesterday, is the reason why Johnny Clayton isn't here. Having beaten Johnny Clayton at the Hungarian Darts Trophy just recently, that prevented the Welshman, the all-conquering Welshman, from attending here in Salzburg. That's his nemesis. You're looking at him right here. Plenty of oohs and ahs from the crowd, weren't there? Getting into it tonight and Friday night.
A few more in tonight under restrictions. I think that's pretty much the maximum allowed in.
100.
Good-natured crowd even last night. Even though it wasn't packed to the rafters, they were knowledgeable and very supportive of all the players.
It was sparse.
a little bit.
Like one of my exhibitions before you start. Now,
So both these players just feeling each other out, feeling their form out a little bit in the opening encounters, the opening visits here. Murnan now on a finish.
They've met on one occasion, very recently, of course,
97.
In the Gibraltar Darts Trophy qualifiers. Joe Murnan winning 6-4.
Adam, you acquire 140.
So chance here for Gawlas. Good opener. Bit of a think about that one. 16s.
88. Joe, you acquire 16.
As you were saying, Joe has been around a while. Made the last 32 of the PDC World Championship back in 2016.
50.
Well, that was a little wide, a little scrappy, and now this is a bona fide chance for the teenager from the Czech Republic.
Break of throw opportunity.
46.
Well, same pattern there for Gawlas as Murnan. Let's him back in now, the Lancastrian. Not what he wanted. He'll have one dart.
8.
But he'll need more than that.
Adam, you acquire 10.
They could both find themselves up in the madhouse unless Gawlas can find double 5.
That's
first little blow, second significant blow perhaps, to the teenager Adam Gawlas. And just a release of tension there. He can relax now, take the darts into the next leg, and he's got his nose in front.
77.
How much, Mace, if anything, have you seen of Gawlas?
Well, his breakthrough really came in the World Cup for me in terms of showing his ability. He's played in the World Cup on two occasions. And looks a bit of a player. Big lad for 19.
140.
A decent visit, that. The Tip Sports Premier League was founded in 2020 in the Czech Republic, and he took that title in all Czech competitions. So
100.
On that measurement, at least, he's the best player, you could argue, in the Czech Republic at the moment.
Yeah, he's played in 24 development tour events. He's still doing his apprenticeship.
123.
Those of you with an outstanding memory might remember 2019 down in Minehead. The World Youth Championship final, where he lost to Luke Humphries. We have seen him before on ITV.
Good shout, I forgot about that one then.
75. Joe, you acquire 121.
He's in 186. 1-2-1 now for Murnan. To break straight back. Not going to happen.
57. Adam, you acquire 86.
16. Oh, that was close.
Another one of those next door for 2-0.
70.
Well, that was a bit unlucky there, wasn't it? Just came off the barrel.
Yeah. 64.
Oh, this is a great chance for Joe to get into this game and An instant break back. One dart at tops.
24.
Not seen the doubles yet, Murnan.
Adam, you acquire 16.
So, double eights. Adam Gawlas to go 2-0 up. Fours. Snakes and ladders. Down he goes.
14.
Double two.
Joe, you require 40.
Another missed opportunity for Murnan. Just settling down. His first chalk on the board. He's back up at double five.
35.
Well, mates, the finishing has not been virtuoso stuff here in Salzburg so far, has it?
Can't finish his dinner at the moment.
Not a problem you had just before we came on air, I noticed, Chris.
He's on the second leg.
Yeah, that was very nerveless in the end from Adam Gawlas. Two good markers, and he takes a 2-0 lead. Joe Murnan suddenly finding himself under real pressure here.
It's called a dirty bulk, Ned.
28.
Certainly dirty.
All credit to you. We had the same thing to eat. I was amazed you completed.
We're similar physiques.
60.
Well, he doesn't look phased, does he, Gawlas? At all. It's a cool customer.
Yeah, he's a fairly laid-back character.
95.
As I say, he dispensed of Johnny Clayton, and that's no mean feat, given what we know of Johnny Clayton's form of late at the Hungarian Darts Trophy, and then did go on eventually to lose to José de Souza. But only
no
by 6-5, went right the way to the 11th leg, that one.
And there was no shame in that defeat.
Not exactly a whitewash.
96.
That's yet to really spark into life, this game.
Well, you'll see a different version of Murnan once he gets a leg on the board. The most recent match I remember him being involved in was against Lurchbacher.
137.
He's had some good wins recently against the likes of Jeffrey Deswan, Willie O'Connor, Scott Mitchell, yep. Chris Dobie, Big Moore. So there's nothing wrong with his game at the moment, but tonight, so far, hasn't ignited.
123.
Good visit from Gawlas and puts Murnan under a little bit of pressure here.
60. Adam, you require 138.
He's going to have to come back.
59.
Could have done with a treble there. Didn't fall for him. Murnan on 167. Two good darts. Ah, look at that, would you? Where did that come from? Well, I never. 167, easy as you like. A bolt out of the blue. Brilliant from Murnan.
And that's what makes this game so enjoyable, yet so frustrating to play.
Wow. Huh. Yeah, all that fumbling around on tens and fives.
Yeah.
And
he had eight darts at a double. Didn't get anywhere near any of them, and then just finds the ball for a 167.
Well, that should ignite him. If nothing's going to. I mean, what a finish that was from Murnan. What the game needed, I sense, as well. Getting a bit of support for that from the Salzburg crowd as well.
60.
We're beginning to pick their favourites. Murnan winning them over to some extent with that brilliant 167 checkout. Highest of the tournament so far, isn't it, Mace?
Yes.
47.
Sorry, it wasn't Lurchbacher, it was Clearmacher he beat 6-5 in a thriller in that the most recent, or the final of the Euro Tours to qualify for this one. He's a 6-5 winner, and then
57.
Went down to Joe Cullen, 6-1.
$140.
That's it.
Both players at the moment in the high 70s in the averages. You'd expect that to go up now as they get into their stride in this game.
So many missed doubles early on, wasn't it?
60.
Absolutely destroys an average.
Oh, he could have done with a big visit here. 82. Needed that last dart, but 140 would have done him a lot of good there.
Some good ties this evening. As I said, this one was a bit of a pick'em. And so's the next one. Rutajski versus Noppert.
140.
All the matches, best of 11, first to 6.
Leaves him on tops, 44. But Adam Gawlas has a chance here to make it 3-1.
4, 12. 12 for double 16.
Perfect. A corner. Perfect finish from Adam Gawlas. He does what he needed to do. Left Joe Murnan stranded there.
Game on.
But Murnan just edging a little bit closer now. Confident hold last time out. Can he repeat it again and make it 3-2? Keep himself within 44. Touching distance of Gawlas going into the break. Very important, this leg, isn't it? Yeah. 4-1 and 3-2.
He just doesn't look like he's scoring heavy enough to force a break of throw out of Gawlas. That's the 59. Way this one's playing out. And if you look at the stats and the numbers, it backs that up. Not unless he can find a surge of scoring power like this.
He's listening to you, Chris. He's listening to you. It's what he needed. And Murnan has to focus on just getting to the break at 3-2 now. He's got to think about breaking the Gawlas throw, the other side of the break, where everything can change, the whole momentum can switch. That's what it's about, isn't it? Breaking this match 100. Down into small, manageable chunks, each visit at a time.
Yeah, very much in set play. That's exactly how you play it. You do break the match down.
60.
And then over the long, sort of the world match play, where it's the long leg play, you break it down into to mini sessions.
96.
Chipping away, Murnan still in control of the leg. That's a wild
85.
One.
Big visit here from Gawlas, piles the pressure on again, doesn't it?
Well, if he can find a couple of trebles, it certainly does. And that 60 gives Murnan two visits to get rid of this 1-3-2 and go into the break. Only one leg behind. 17 for top.
Bullseye big, isn't he?
92.
Wow.
Such a lovely finish, that. The ball double 16 on the 1-3-2.
140. Good visit. Joe Murnan, though, tops 40. To make it 3-2 at the break. Gets
he's
the job done.
The fifth leg, Joe Murnan.
A little fist pump aimed more at himself than anybody else. He's still in this match. Could have been blown away by Gawlas there. But that 1-6-7, blimey, that might have changed everything. Brings the Salzburg crowd to their feet. We have a match. In some style, age Adam Gawlas, who has
100.
That one leg lead and has still got that break of throw, and the averages are just creeping up again.
Yeah, they've picked up.
58.
Too many visits without a trouble for Murnan. Needs to find another gear from somewhere.
97.
Well, talk about love the darts. Joe Murnan must love this sport. I mean, his career, Chris, when you think about it, to gain a tour card in the first place, but then to lose it and regain it through Q School, not once, but twice, says an awful lot about his passion for the sport, doesn't it?
Oh, and his tenacity, because Q School is an absolute minefield. Let's not forget Glenn Durrant, who went on to, of course, win the Premier League. He only just about ended up getting a card. So that shows you how tough it is.
Adam, you require 170.
Right, Gawlas, 170. Good start. Ooh.
98.
Well, very steady start, isn't it?
180 or 177 is what's required here, and even then, it might not be enough.
46.
He's in trouble here.
Adam, you require 72.
72. Again, just not doing anything on the Gawlas throw, and that top corner at double 16 for a second time.
Exactly where he checked out last time on double 16. He is a very, very steady player, Adam Gawlas. No real fluctuations in his form, unlike his opponents so far this evening, who's been subpar and then with the occasional flash of brilliance.
Well, that was the best leg of the match so far, a 15 darter there for Adam.
140.
Just went north of the treble there, didn't it, Gawlas? But a big 140, and effectively he's taken the darts in this leg.
140.
Good response, though, from Joe Murnan, matching him.
Had five consecutive holds to throw after a break of throw in leg one. There's the darts used in each of the six legs played. Give that a bit of shoulder. My goodness.
Third consecutive 140 from these players. Looks for another treble. Almost finds it.
99.
Needed it to leave a finish of 167. Perfectly placed that one high and middle.
This is a terrific leg from Adam Gawlas.
This is what he's capable of.
Perfect. Big lead now against the throw.
A possible 11 darter.
85.
So two Adam darts for 11 41. From Adam Gawlas. Double 16. It's been flawless on it so far, pretty much.
9.
Well,
we know what Murnan can do with a big finish. Took the 167 out in leg three. Needs four 18s. Oh dear, oh dear.
Now, 40. Adam Gawlas will have 32. Three at double 16 to go 5-2 up. Only needed one more chance. The young man from the Czech Republic.
Well, off the break, Ned, he's gone 15 and 13, a hold and a break of throw.
With the best will in the world, Joe Murnan would have struggled even on his best form to match that, but he hasn't been playing with his best form.
And that's been a surge, hasn't it? He's put nearly 10 points on his average here, Gawlas. And he's in again.
He's seeing that treble 20 huge right now, isn't he?
Well, this is the kind of surge Murnan needed to get back into the match.
Hello.
He's relaxed now, isn't he? He thinks the game's up. He's starting to flow.
Has an opportunity here, needs to capitalise, needed that big 19.
Nothing more frustrating than seeing that little opening and not being able to take it.
Isn't quite enough, really. Gawlas switching now.
Rock solid.
Might go up
lift
again.
Lift of the trailing leg.
Yeah. Good switch, good last dart. Keeps the pressure firmly on Murnan.
There's a finish. There's Murnan.
137. Adam, you require 151.
There's no quitting him, that's for sure.
Treble 17 for tops. Didn't want that.
92 remaining. 82 remaining. Went for the 42 for tops.
Do you require 102?
Right, 102. This has to go for Joe Murnan. Has to go. 80. Yes, what a finish. And once again, he looks to the heavens as if to say, where's that come from? Why can't I do that every time?
Well, the starts off the break net have been of the highest quality. A 15 darter in leg six for Gawlas. Then a 180 and a 13 dart breaker throw for Gawlas, and that was a 12 dart. Both players having 180s in leg eight. and a 10 plus finish of 102. And then starts the leg at 48.
Well, hats off to Joe Murnan for that finish, keeping the game alive like that. That's, in many ways, Chris, that's a microcosm of his career right there, isn't it?
Gutsy.
Almost down and out, comes back. Will not give up, Joe Murnan.
125.
And Adam Gawlas must be wondering how on earth he lost that leg. How did that happen?
Well, it was a wonderful leg from both.
60.
Steady as you go from both so far in this leg, matching each other. Good visit though from Murnan just now.
85.
Well, that treble was there for the taking, wasn't it?
A little bit of pressure off Murnan here. Again, placement of that first start is perfect.
137.
That's better from Murnan, isn't it? 200 lead.
The average is now closing in on the 90 mark for Gawlas.
59.
86 for Murnan. Oh, sorry, 87.3 for Murnan. Tops for a 14 darter.
Yes.
Games on the ninth leg.
5-4, and suddenly that looks much better, doesn't it? But still, he is in within one leg of defeat here, Joe Murnan. No room for error. Has to win the last
legs two. From the break. Absolutely brilliant. 15, 13, 12, 14.
Well, a rare visit without a treble from Adam Gawlas. Now Murnan just has to kick the door down now. No choice, he needs another treble, gets
140.
It.
And he's looked unfazed throughout. Nick, a wonderful poker player.
Very good response from Adam Gawlas.
100.
Solid enough. 'Cause tense now, isn't it, Chris? For both players, you can really feel it. Reaching for that treble and getting it, Gawlas.
Back to back 140s when he looked in a spot of bother.
80.
Now,
Adam, you acquire
how important
160
was that? 161 for Gawlas. Good start. Treble 17. Tidies up.
97
scored. That'll leaves do. Him 64. 181, not a finish for Joe Murnan. And two poor darts. And the third one wasn't great either.
Adam,
you a rueful glance there at the three errant darts that he picks out of the board. 32. And the double 16.
One match dart.
Oh, 32. Well, he's had a love-hate relationship with that double so far in this match. And that was more hate than love. Big ask though for Murnan, still on 155 and missing the trebles.
90.
Going for the ball, that hasn't let him down. It's just stay on that every visit. It's barely missed it, has he, Chris?
No, he's been mustered on the bullseye.
Right. He only needed one last time he had three at this. Double 8. For the match.
Yes!
Checkmate! Adam Gawlas does it. Put under pressure at the end by a tenacious opponent. But look at him, 19 years of age, and making his mark here in Austria. Joe Murnan beaten and going home. This man dancing his way into the next round. Adam Gawlas, what more have we got from him?